Yes.
Okay, so I'm gonna flip it over. Okay, so if you remember what we're doing is we are solving indefinite integrals, so that's suckers with no numbers here, okay? Another way to say it is we're finding the antiderivative of some problems, some integrands that aren't real basic, okay? They're something that's complicated, something that has normally a product, normally some, you would say some sort of composition of a function, something cubed or squared or to the fourth or whatever. And we can't just be like, oh, I know that, that's tangent, or that's tangent cubed, or secant to the fourth, or anything like that. And so instead what we have to do is we have to substitute, come up with some sort of substitution variable relationship between another variable u and some part of this, and then turn all of these items into other items, and then take the integral and then substitute them back and expand it, okay? So, today we're going to continue that process. But there's going to be a problem. So this is our final U substitution problems. I have to go for secret messages. Okay, so if you remember last week, we looked at stuff like this. Now, if we wanted to, we could expand this 2x plus 5 times 2x plus 5 times 2x plus 5, you know, and then FOIL it out. Anybody feel like doing that?
No.
Yeah. So instead what we'll do is we'll find an interesting u here. So we'll say u equals, and I'm open to suggestions. Anyone a little bit experienced now, but I know it's been the weekend. 2x plus 5 is actually a good Mike's substitution value. My experience gives you the thumbs up on that one. Okay? So I say u equals 2x plus 5. The next step in the process was always to take the derivative with respect to x. So du over dx equals 2. Then we're going to try to get that dx over here so we can say du equals 2 dx. Now I've got a couple other things going on here. So if we look at this, I'm going to replace that 2x plus 5 to the fifth. I'm now going to replace that with a u to the fifth. So that item is taken care of. The dx, I also have a 3. It's 3 and dx. I don't have a 3 multiplied by here, so what I might have to do is I have to divide both sides by 2. So du divided by 2 equals dx. Well, how could I get a 3 there?
Divide 3 by 2.
Multiply, yes. I could, if I multiply this side by 3 and this side by 3, then I actually end up with the 3 dx, which is what I was looking for. So I'm going to replace the 3 dx with 3 halves du. I'm taking some liberties here, but I feel like y'all can handle that. Multiplication, commutative term, it doesn't matter which way you multiply or which order you multiply them in. Great. But there's a problem here. This is what this whole lesson is about, so to speak. What item is unaccounted for there?
The x.
And I can't just put an x right here because then I would have, I could just leave the x right there, but then I wouldn't be able to do what I really want to do, which is just literally take, you know, the antiderivative of u to the fifth. Because if I have an x right there, then I have a product and we don't have an antiderivative product rule, okay? So what I need to do is somehow go over here and figure out something to replace that x. Preferably put that x in terms of u. Okay? So this problem here, this is what I call a solve for x situation. Because we have a singular x. And the way that we're going to deal with this is by solving for x in this equation right here. I'll carry the work on down over here. I would, we're pretty good at this since we're calculus students. I'll just subtract 5 from both sides, so u minus 5. Then divide both sides by 2. See if y'all agree with that. U minus 5 divided by 2 equals x.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Well, great. Well, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to substitute this, u minus 5 divided by 2, in for the x. But unfortunately, I'm going to have to. I don't have enough room inside right here. So. So replacing the x, I have parentheses u minus 5 over 2. And then this was u to the fifth, and then we also have the du carry off over there. So it's like a v over to u to the u. There it is. Okay, so we have everything in terms of u. Now we're just going to do a little bit of manipulation so we can get ready to do our antiderivative stuff. This 2 and the 3 halves, I'm going to pull that completely out of the integral, so we'll write that in front as 3 fourths. And then we have u minus 5 times u to the 5th du. At this point, it's going to be best for us just to go ahead and distribute that u to the 5th. So we have 3/4 the integral of u to the 6th minus 5 u to the 5th du. Carry that over here. 3/4 times. All right, class. Monday morning, but we're awake now. What's the antiderivative of u to the 6th?
U to the 7th.
Over seven.
Mm-hmm. Minus 5 u to the
6
over 6. Plus c. I think my answer to you is going to want us to distribute that 3/4, so that'll make our grading life a little bit easier. Let's see if I'm right. Yep, I am correct. So, let's go ahead and distribute that 3/4. So this is going to be 3 over 28. And you know what? We need to do this extra step anyway, because we need to substitute back in for u. U was 2x plus 5. So 2x plus 5 to the 7th minus distributing that 3/4 3 times. Well, that 3 would cancel, would reduce to a 1, and this would reduce to a 2. So that would be 5 over, so the 2, 4 times 2, so 5/8. Instead of writing u to the 6th, I'll write 2x plus 5. To the 6th. And then 3/4 of a constant is just another constant. So 3 over 28 times 2x plus 5 to the 7th minus 5 over 8 times 2x plus 5 to the 6th plus c. Yep, that looks great. And that's our answer there. Let's flip through the rest of the problems there, 13 through the end. Let's find one that maybe looks sufficiently weird that we can do together. Any requests? That one's got a 2 to the 4th, that one's got a -4th, -4th, That's in the denominator, but that's just going to be a negative 4. This one right here, maybe 17?
Mm-hmm. Yes. It's 4.
So first thing we might want to do is just rewrite this as 4x times x plus 3 to the negative 4th dx. What is a U value that y'all like? X plus 3. So then, working on down the line, du over dx, 1. So du equals dx, that's kind of interesting. But I don't just have a regular old dx here, I have a 4dx. So we'll just multiply both sides by 4.
And then solve for x.
And then we will solve for x. That's not too bad here. U minus 3 equals x. Alright, so the 4 dx is taken care of with a 4 du. The x is replaced with u minus 3. And the x plus 3 to the negative 4th is replaced with a u to the negative 4th. Let's bring that 4 out in front of the integral so we don't have to mess with it. And we will distribute this u to the negative 4th. Test your skills here. U to the negative 4th times u.
1 over.
Oh. No. You could do 1 over, yeah, but we're going to keep these variables in the numerators so we do the integral. Right, now I'm just distributing.
Here. Oh, okay, so it'd be
u to the negative
3.
Yep, u to the negative 3 minus 3u to the negative 4. Because if you remember, this is an exponent of 1. Mm-hmm. When you multiply the similar bases, then you add the exponents, 1 minus 4 to negative 3. Alright, and so we're off to the races. This is going to be 4. I'll put the bracket here. Now we'll do the antiderivative of u to the negative 3. Antiderivative of u to the negative 3 is going to be u to the... Yep, u to the negative 2 over negative 2 minus 3 u to the negative 3 over negative 3 plus c.
So this is the antiderivative.
That's the antiderivative step, yep. So, we'll go ahead and distribute. We might be able to do all this here in one step. So, how good are you? So the 4 and the negative 2 is going to reduce to a negative 2 just in the numerator. So, negative 2, and instead of writing u to the negative 2, I'm going to write x plus 3. The negative 2. That minus and that negative cancel, so I end up with a plus. The 3 over 3 completely reduced, 1 over 1. And so when this 4 comes over, it's just going to be the 4 times, instead of writing u the negative 3, I'll substitute x plus 3. 3. And the 4 times the constant is just another constant. Now when we check our work, I think the answer document is going to put all negative exponents into the denominator, so it's going to probably have something like this. Negative 2 over x plus 2 squared plus 4 over x plus 2 cubed plus c. And I'll verify that here. Negative 2 over x plus, well, I don't know why I'm putting plus 2. X plus 3. Right. Plus, I think you deal with that. 4 x plus 3 cubed plus c. Okay? In previous years, we had what you have for your homework right now is actually two separate homeworks. One of the homework was U substitution, and it was just all basic U substitution, very straightforward. Then the next homework was U substitution with some trig and what I call these solve for X problems. And that was great, except it was just too easy because you could just be like, oh, it was just do the same process like 8 to 10 times. So what I did is I shortened both of those assignments, combined them, and the added challenge now is you're not quite sure if the problem that you're working on is a solve for x problem or a not solve for x problem. But so it's kind of a little bit of a mystery, but not that much of a mystery. It's only one type, you know, one or the other. So just make sure that everything when you're doing your U substitution, make sure that everything is accounted for. Okay, I've kind of been doing that by doing that underlying thing, but I've been super consistent. Make sure everything's accounted for. If you have a stray x laying around, it's probably a solve for x problem. Do that extra step, and you'll be good to go. But as always, if you're not sure about your answer, how can you check to make sure it's right?
The derivative of it.
Yep, take the derivative, see if it ends up equaling this integrand. Okay? All right. This is a little bit of a computationally heavy assignment, kind of. You'll have the rest of class to take care of this. And also tomorrow, I will let you get this work done.
So it'd be this one, right?
The one that says homework. Our one says HW on the front. Let's see. On Wednesday, I am expecting you to have notes on 9.1, chapter 9, lesson 1. We're skipping ahead just to deal with slope fields for 2 days. So 9.1, if you want to be a superstar, 9.2 is going to be due on Thursday. And you know, if you want to, 6.1, do Friday. I believe it's not tomorrow, but it's next Tuesday when the official Hill College classes start. If we get information before that to help you set up all the online material and stuff like that, then that's we'll spend a day doing that. We'll spend like a class period. Alright. Yes, you may. Anybody else need a copy of homework?
I may go to the restroom.
You may go to the restroom. Anybody else need a copy of homework?
I was feeling left out, but that's the homework.
Mm-hmm.